the ninth question of exercise 1.3. Here the function is from positive real numbers to minus 5 infinity. And the f of x is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 5. You have to show that the function is invertible. And f inverse is this much you have to show. So first of all, if you want to show that the function is invertible, you need to show that the given function is 1,1 and on 2. So first of all, I will show that this is 1,1 function. For showing 1,1 function, what we have to do? The given function, first of all, we have to take it as f of x1 and f of x2. So f of x1 is equal to 9x1 square plus 6x1 minus 5. And f of x2 is equal to 9x2 square plus 6x2 minus 5. Now what is the procedure? We have to assume that f of x1 is equal to f of x2 and we have to show that x1 is equal to x2. So here, f of x1 is equal to f of x2, I assumed. And afterwards, I put the value of f of x1 and f of x2. That is 9x1 square plus 6x1 minus 5 is equal to 9x2 square plus 6x2 minus 5. Now, all the terms you bring towards left hand side, then minus 5 and this minus 5, it will cancel. Only 9 into x1 square minus x2 square plus 6 into x1 minus x2 will be remaining. Now, from these two terms, again x1 minus x2, we can take it common. So, from here also x1 minus x2 we can take common. From here also x1 minus x2 we can take common. Because this can be written as x1 plus x2 into x1 minus x2. So, when I will take the x1 minus x2 common from this term. I took x1 minus x2 here. Then here only 9 is remaining. Into, then here. From x1 square minus x2 square, when x1 minus x2 came, then x1 plus x2 is there. Then plus 6, which is equal to 0. Now students, you can see that the product of these two terms equal to 0. Product of these two terms is equal to 0 means either one of the term is 0, otherwise both the terms are 0. But here you can see that our x1 and x2 belongs to the positive real numbers. Already it was mentioned in the question. Do you remember? Consider the function f is equal to r plus 2 minus 5 infinity. It means our domain was the collection of positive real numbers. It means x1 and x2 belongs to the positive real numbers. It means these two are positive numbers. If x1 is a positive number, x2 is also a positive number, then sum of these two is positive. That if we are multiplying with 9, again it will be a positive number. And that positive number if you are adding with 6, that always it will be a positive number. We won't be getting this term as 0. So I written here that 9 into x1 plus x2 plus 6 cannot be 0. Then which term can be 0? X1 minus x2 can be 0. If x1 minus x2 is 0 means from there we will be getting x1 is equal to x2. It means the function f is 1,1. F is a 1,1 function. Now next we have to show that f is onto. For showing f is onto, first what we are doing? We are changing the dependency. Then afterwards whatever value we are getting as x, that again we are putting as f of x equal to y. From there, at last, after putting the value of x, we will show that the f of whatever value we put it, that is equal to y. That is the procedure for showing the function as onto. So here, first of all, if you not understood, then listen. Just you watch the video. Afterwards, okay, it will become clear. First of all, if x is the element in the domain and if f is a function and y is the image of this, it means the y can be written as f of x. Okay, so here f of x is equal to y and y belongs to minus 5 infinity. It means here the codomain is the collection of these numbers, which is starting from minus 5 up to infinity. Now, what I will do, I will change the dependency. For that, this f of x is equal to y, we know. So, the given f of x, I will write it as y. So, y is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 1. From here, I will find the value of x. So, simple calculation, it is difficult. So, what I will do? I will try to write in terms of a quadratic equation. 9x square I written here. Then 6x written here. Now, these two terms I written together as a constant term. So, now this is in a quadratic equation form, general form. Now, using quadratic formula, I am trying to find the value of x. Minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So, I put the values here. Okay. And then I got the value of x. So, here when we will solve this, the value of x we will be getting as minus 1 plus or minus under the root y plus 6 by 3. Solving part you can do. Okay. So, here also be careful. The domain is the collection of positive real numbers I told. So, if I am taking minus 1 plus under the root y plus 6 by 3 means that is possible. But if I am taking the second option, minus 1 minus of under the root y minus 6 by 3, then we will be getting a negative numbers that not belongs to the positive real numbers. So, we won't be taking the x value as this. We will be considering only the value of x as the minus 1 plus root under the root y plus 6 by 3. Okay. So, I written the x value. So, what I told? First of all, we will change the dependency and we will find the value of x. Okay. Now, this value of x, I will put in the function. Whatever value we got it, that I am going to put in the function. What was the function? Function was f of x is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 5. So, the value of x now I put in this function. So, 9 as it is written in place of x square. This whole term square plus 6 into x. Again I written this value as x minus 5. Now, take the LCM and solve it. Now, while solving this, okay, take the LCM and solve it, then you will be getting as, at last, as y. It means what? We took the function f of x that is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 5. In this x, place of x, we put the value whatever we got it. What was the value which we got? So, here this value of x we put in this function and we shown that this f of x is equal to y. We shown here. It means that whatever values are there in this codomain, all those values, otherwise all those elements have the pre-image, that is the meaning. It means the function is onto function. You have to conclude it. Now, we have to find out the inverse also, because we have to show that f inverse of y is equal to under the root y plus 6 minus 1 by 3. This was given in the question. We have to show that f inverse y is equal to this. So, for that what I will do? F of x is equal to y, we got it. Now, whatever value we got it as x, that we have to put it here. The x value we got it in this way, that I put it here. So, f of under the root y plus 6 minus 1 by 3 is equal to y. Now, you have to shift the y towards right hand side. That will be f inverse of y. It means f inverse of y that is equal to under the root y plus 6 minus 1 by 3. This only we need to show. Okay. So, the same question can be done in another method also. F of x is equal to 9x square plus 6x minus 5. Here, by completing the squaring method, that also you can use it here for showing that x1 is equal to x2. Okay. Here, do you remember in 10th class already you learned by completing the squares how to find the value of x? So first of all, x square coefficient you had to make it as 9. So 9 taken outside. So x square plus 6 by 9, x minus 5 by 9, got it. Now half of the coefficient of x you have to take it. So 6 by 9 means that is 2 by 3. So actually half of 2 by 3 means 1 by 3. So half of the coefficient of x you have to take it. And square of that number you have to add and subtract with the expression. And then convert into the perfect squares. Then you will be getting the 9 into x plus 1 by 3 the whole square minus 6. That is f of x. So f of x is equal to 9 into x plus 1 by 3 the whole square minus 6. So f of x1 can be written as 9 into x1 plus 1 by 3 the whole square minus 6. And f of x2 can be written as 9 into x2 plus 1 by 3 the whole square minus 6. Now for showing it as 1, 1, first we will assume that f of x1 is equal to f of x2. And just compare these two. And after doing the calculation and all, you will be getting x1 is equal to x2. So here, we assume that f of x1 is equal to f of x2. And we got that x1 is equal to x2. It means the function is 1, 1 function. Now, you have to show that it is 1, 2 function. It is like the previous procedure only. F of x we will assume as y. Only the function little bit change here. But afterwards, finally we will be getting the same answer. F of x is 9 into x plus 1 by 3 the whole square minus 6. Already we shown here. That f of x, we have to assume it as y. And for changing the dependency. And from here, you need to find the value of x. So, you will be getting the value of x as under the root y plus 6 minus 1 by 3. Afterwards, what you have to do? The value of x, you have to put in the function. In the function, wherever x is there, you have to put it. That all these things we did in the previous method. Okay? And you have to show that f of x is equal to y. So, here, after getting f of x is equal to y, you have to show that the function is onto function. So, f is 1, 1 and onto. So, it is invertible. That way you can conclude. It is not necessary that you have to do this method. You have to follow the previous method. Some they will be having the doubt that why can't we go for this. Of course you can go for completing the square method also. Okay. Got it?